All right. Hello, everybody. How's everyone doing? Everyone get a chance to check out the keynote this morning? Perfect. I had to leave early, so I didn't catch the end of it. I'm jealous of all of you. So we got a lot going on over the next 48 hours here, starting with what we're talking about today, automating your collection experience. I'm telling you, if you guys have been sitting here all morning, some of my things that I've talked about today, we covered a little bit, but I want to go into a bit more depth on the actual workflows. So, oh, and by the way, I got to tell you guys, I'm so happy to be in person. I don't know, did anybody go to any of the virtual ClioCons last couple of years? They were fun. I'm glad we could do them, but it's nothing like talking to you guys in person. And also a disclaimer, I'm sorry if I gave anyone bad directions this morning. I think I sent people looking for breakfast to the wrong place. I'm sorry. All right. So as it was said, my name is Kyle Bluen. I am what's called a solution specialist here at Clio. It's really just a tech company way of saying that I specialize in the more complicated or newer processes at Clio. So I've actually been heavily involved in supporting our agents with things like payments over the last year since we launched. So there's actually a good chance if any of you guys have signed up for Clio Payments that you may have actually spoken with me over the phone. Today, we're going to break down the existing billing workflow that I'm sure a number of you currently use. Then we'll go through how you can automate aspects of that workflow, as well as trust accounting, to improve your efficiency and give you more time in your day. Now, I'm sure some of the features I talk about today, you may have already been using, maybe one or two of them. But the idea here is to look at the whole big picture and how they can all work together. Now, over 60% of our clients, or 60% of clients prefer to use online payments, automated payment plans, mobile applications, all that kind of new tech stuff to get paid. Not that many people are ready to write a check these days. I'll admit, I still do for my rent, but I'm pretty much the only one that I know that does that. Everybody else is e-transferring, so I'm being old school with that. Now, the idea here is to make paying for the service you provide as easy and accessible as possible. Think of the phrase, set it and forget it. That's our goal with the processes we talk about today. So a lot of firms that I've spoken with have roughly the same standard workflow. Generate your bill, send the bill to the client. Maybe you set up automated payment reminders. That's the first step in automating the experience. And then you wait to get paid. Now, here is an example of an email your client receives with that flow. You can see here on the left, you're choosing to send the bill, and then on the right, you have, you know, the information, option to make that payment. Pretty simple. This is what we talk about, click to pay links. Now, I mentioned earlier, some of you may be using automated reminders. That was the first step in automation that we added in. That's a great one. Is anyone already using automated reminders? Couple here, couple. Good. That's a good first step. You don't want to be wasting your time chasing them down and reminding them to pay you. See, now what happens when you have a client with multiple bills that you need to send them? You share them all at once, you share them one by one, you're going in there and clicking them all, clicking the send on each of them, then they get five emails with all their bills. No, now you can do it all at once with a click of a button. Also, why not start your relationship with your client by getting their payment information on file? When it comes time to bill, you can send it off to your clients. And as well, when it comes time to replenish their trust, if you don't want to have to chase them down, you have the payment information on file and you can charge them. Now, what about when a client walks in? In the last presentation, we talked about the QR code. Yes, we are part of the future now. Use a QR code, get paid right away. Click, go, great. Now, I mentioned earlier talking about multiple bills for your clients. Now, I've spoken with some firms where they want their client to see all the details, so they don't want to just send the recent bill. They want them to be able to see all the charges across the last five bills that they've generated. And so I see them sending individual bills, and that's a long process. You're going to keep clicking send over and over again. A lot of people don't know. You have the option to look at the client's entire outstanding balance and share it all at once. And the client will still get the breakdown. They'll still be able to see all the individual charges, all the individual bills that are related. So in the video playing behind me, you'll see when we can go to the the outstanding balance page, go ahead and click that send button on the entire client balance, and then go ahead and send that to them. If they have five bills, if they have two bills, it doesn't matter. They will see all of their charges in full detail. Now, one of the most difficult parts of the legal billing process can be getting paid. You guys aren't debt collectors. You don't want to be chasing everyone down to get paid. That's exhausting. So with one of our most recent payments features, that process gets a little bit easier. Now, when you have Clio Payments on your account, you're able to send your client a link requesting them to enter their payment information. So whether that's a credit card or an e-check, and then it's stored on file in Clio. The best part is, since it's entirely through Clio, it's all PCI compliant. You're not having to worry about storing that information somewhere secure. It's all in Clio, it's all taken care of. Now, if we look behind me here, that is how you're gonna go. You're gonna go to the matter, you're gonna click that getting the payment information link. I'm gonna copy that over. Now you can send that in an email to your client. And then on the next slide here, this is what they'll see when they click on that link. They see the option to enter in their payment information. Now it's stored in Clio. Now when it's time to replenish their trust, time to charge them, you're already got it, you're already ready. I've spoken with a lot of firms since we've launched this feature. We launched it, I want to say back in April of this year. A lot of firms have been adopting this into their workflow as part of their initial agreement. There's, you know, they'll set up an agreement that we're going to have payment information on file. We're going to provide you with your bill. And if you don't pay it within the allotted time, you know, 2 weeks, a month, we'll charge the payment information on file. This way, there's no more of that chasing down. You already have it. You can also use that same saved payment information to set up a payment plan. Like we mentioned, it can be set up for bi-weekly, monthly, or even just a singular post-dated transaction. You can see here below as what I have in as an example for pulling e-check information saved to make that payment plan. And you can see here on the next page, it's confirming the information, the frequency of the payment, what it's being paid through, and then you go ahead and just create that payment plan. Now, I mentioned earlier, if someone walks into your office and they want to pay you, no longer do you have to store to take their credit card and type it into the computer, and now you're handling it, or try to have them go to your computer and do it for you. Simple. Bring up the QR code. They click on, they scan it with their phone, then they go ahead and enter in whatever saved card they want to use, make that payment. Easy peasy. Quick. And now, you'd be surprised with the amount of firms I've spoken with that don't even know you can make a trust request in Clio. How many here use the trust request feature right now? Okay, good. A good chunk of you. I'm not too worried then. But I want to take a look at a couple different tools here at your disposal to help you manage these funds. So, trust request process. We all know this one. Everyone who's using it. With this feature, you can generate the trust request for the amount you want from your clients, send it to them. They make a payment just like a bill, and it gets paid, and it shows up in Clio automatically. No manual entry, no recording for you to have to do, all taken care of. Now, seeing here on the slide, this is what an example of making that trust request looks like. Now, a lot of firms I've spoken with require a minimum balance in their client's trust accounts at all times. Want to make sure that, you know, they always have that there. So we have what's called an evergreen management feature. This allows you to get notified if your client's funds dip below that amount. So you know if you're running low and it needs to be addressed. So when you get that notification, it allows you to request additional funds, or like I mentioned earlier, use that stored payment information on file and go ahead and replenish those funds. So, example in the slide here, setting up the amount that you want to be notified on, what the minimums are, so you're on top of your client's trust balance. So you can even make payment plans designated for the trust account. So as you can see in the example on screen here, we're setting up $100 monthly payment going into trust, and you can set a total limit. So in this case, we have said pay up to $2,000. Once the amount's been charged, the payment plan will end. So in this case, $100 is going into the trust account for the next 20 months, essentially. Some firms specifically use this feature because maybe their state requires them to have all payments go into trust. They can't have anything go into their operating account right away. So they like to use payment plans specifically into their trust accounts. Now, once you have the funds from your client video, you can apply them towards a bill following the steps in this video really quickly. I imagine anyone here who holds trust funds and records them in Clio is probably doing this part, but in case you're not, go ahead here, you can see in this step, one important note that I really always have to disclaim here. Clio does not currently have the ability to move funds in your actual bank account when you do this. So when you go ahead and click this apply trust, apply it to the bill, as far as Clio is concerned, it's done. You still have to go into your bank account and move those funds actually. Maybe one day that'll be different. We want, you know how we keep growing, we keep changing. But as of right now, that's where we're at. When it comes to reconciling accounts and making sure that you have your trust funds where they should be, we have so many tools in place for you, so many reports that can be utilized. We have things like the trust management report, lets you look at how much you have in your trust account for each client compared to how much you have work unbilled. So you can know if you're starting to, you know, balance out, maybe you need to look at getting some more trust funds. Trust listing report gives you a good high level overview of your trust balances across all your clients. And then the ledger report will show you the ins and outs, individual transactions on each of your clients' accounts. Now, we also have some tools in place, like integrating with things like QuickBooks Online. I'm actually, shameless plug here, doing a workshop tomorrow called Integrating QuickBooks Online with your Clio account. Highly recommend to check it out if you want to see what QBO can do for your firm, especially if, you know, maybe you've looked at it in the past and you think it might be a little intimidating. I know, I'm not an accountant, it can be intimidating, but the goal with the presentation is to make it a little easier. So I want to thank everyone so much for coming to this presentation. If you want to learn more about these processes, you can always go over to our product lab. I'll be over in the Success Center for most of the convention. Again, my name is Kyle Bluen, and thank you guys so much for being here.